everyone! So as you can see, today's look is a little bit more dramatic than normal, just because normally I wouldn't do bold lips with bold eyes, but it's quite a popular little trend recently, so I thought I'd give it a go. And I am very, very happy with the results, so it's always good to try something new. In terms of where I would wear this, I think it's perfect for any kind of special occasion, any kind of formal event during the evening. I think it is more of an evening look than a day look. I'm sure you can understand why. But if you do want to wear it during the day, go for it. It's all about, you know, doing what you would normally do or feel comfortable with. So anyway, on to the video. So I've already done one eye just because it makes the video a little bit faster. So for the tutorial, I'm going to be using the BH Cosmetics Day and Night palette. So if you watch my other video, I used another BH Cosmetics palette. I got this one at the same time, but I just didn't get around to doing a tutorial with it yet. So it has kind of like 30 colours for, I would say, kind of autumn or fall. So it has like your kind of reds and blues and greens. And then on this side, it has colours that are more suitable, I would say, for like spring and summer, for those of us in Australia. It also has, you know, the really, really dark colours and the really, really light colours. So it is perfect for, you know, day and night. I just thought I'd mention that because it is quite a good like multi-use palette for those of you who might not have the money to go out and buy lots of individual colours, but you want to be able to use a lot of the different colours, if that makes sense. As always, if you want to check it out, prices and links and everything are down below, so check it out if you wanna. But I'll get started with the video now. Alright, so I'm going to start with my NYX eyeshadow base in white. So you just want to apply that all over your eyelid. Then I'm going to take my NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in Milk and apply that underneath my lash line. So that's just going to ensure that the eyeshadow is as vibrant as possible. Now taking my palette, I'm going to use this shade here. I'm using my Sigma Eye Shading E55 brush. Get that all over the brush and just apply it to your whole eyelid. Then I want to take my random Coastal Scents round fluffy brush and get that same colour just to blend it out. Then I want to take the Sigma Pencil E30 brush and that same pinky orangey colour and apply that underneath the lash line, but stopping at about here because I want to put another colour in that corner area. With that same brush, I'm going to grab this gold, where is it, this one here, this gold colour here, which is right next to that fluoro yellow colour, and I'm going to apply that in the area that I didn't apply that red colour and bring it halfway to the middle of the bottom lashes. That just means that it's going to blend in with that reddish colour and look really nice and blended and like kind of nice and gradient. But it'll have a nice gradient, that's the one. And then I want to bring in the inner corner as well and start blending it up into the top eyeshadow. Then I want to grab that same E55 brush that I used earlier and apply that gold colour by patting it on to the inner corner of the eye. Now I'm going to take a Sigma shader lid E56 brush, which is just a little bit smaller than an eyeshadow brush, and take the colour directly next to that red colour, this kind of darker bronzy brown, and apply that in the outer crease. Next, I'm going to take a large shader E60 brush by Sigma and this very, I think it's actually is just plain white, yeah it is, very, very light creamy white, and apply that on my brow bone as a highlight. And then I'm going to take the colour directly next to it, which is the same kind of shade but it's just sparkly, whoops, and so that'll just add a little bit of shimmer and highlight it even more. Just lightly though, you don't have to be too over dramatic. Next I'm going to take my Bobbi Brown Ultra Fine Eyeliner Brush, which is the best eyeliner brush in the universe, and Maybelline's Eye Studio Gel Liner, I think. Yeah, Gel Liner in Black is Black. And I'm just going to cover the brush in that. And I'm just going to do a fairly thick line starting in the middle and then working my way that way and then outwards. Next, I'm going to take this Revlon Colorstay eyeliner crayon thing, which is just like a retractable one, and apply that in my waterline and my upper lash line inside. I think it's tight lining it. I think that's what it's called, yeah. Now, because that's a really, really clean, crisp line, and I'm not really into that look, I'm going to take my Bobbi Brown eyeliner brush and in the corner the plain matte black shadow and then press this eyeshadow into my lash line where my actual lashes are, because that's just going to smoke it out a lot. So I'm just going to press it and then drag down, so kind of go like this across my lash line. So next I am going to apply just a light coat of mascara on my top lashes. This one is probably my favourite at the moment, which is the Maybelline 1x1 mascara. And if you guys have been watching me for a while, you would know that I never wear false lashes. And today I'm going to, because I felt like something different and I don't know, I think it kind of makes the look a little bit more dramatic. I'm just going to use these cheapo lashes. You can find ones that are very, very similar, like on eBay and stuff, but I just thought they were nice. Now I think it's dried enough, so I'm just going to get that eyeliner again, the black one, the gel liner, sorry, and go over that band. So I'm going to take my Bobbi Brown bronzer brush and my Benefit Hoola bronzer, which I have just fallen back in love with. I haven't used it for a while. And then just any kind of card. This one's just a gift card, I think. I want to do a pretty strong contour with this card. And now to do the same on this side, so finding the hollows of your cheeks. Just about there. And just start pressing that on. I love this brush because it's just so fat that it covers such a large space, but it really nicely blends it out. And you can see you've got that line there. That one's quite a lot more dramatic than this one, so I'm just going to blend that down a bit. Just softly diffuse the line. And do the same with this one. And then bring that up into my temples as well. And the blush I'm going to be using is by Jordana in Touch of Pink, number 18, with my Bobbi Brown blush brush. Get that all over the brush, tap off any of the excess, smile and apply it to the apples of your cheeks and blend it into the bronzer. Next is time for highlighter. So for this one I'm going to use my MAC Mineralized Skin Finish in Lightscapade, which is a personal favourite of mine at the moment. And I'm going to take it on my MAC 116 brush, which is what I use for highlighting. And just smile again so that I find the kind of C-shape or the highest points of my cheekbones and apply it on there. So you can see that it adds a really nice kind of glow to the tops of my cheeks compared to this side, which is kind of eh. And here this side, which is a lot more glowy. I'm going to use this NYX Long Lip Pencil, or Long Pencil Lip. Long Pencil Lip. That seems a little bit like dyslexic, you can't even read it. Long Pencil Lip. Long Lip Pencil, that's gotta be a mistake. Anyway, this one is in the colour Plush Red. So that they're all filled in, I'm going to use my NYX Black Label Lipstick in Cherry, which is, it looks really, really, really dark in the tube, but it's actually not that dark, and apply that. And I just realized that I actually forgot to apply mascara to my bottom lashes. I filmed like the whole entire end of the video, the start of the video, everything, the thumbnail like picture, and then I went to touch my bottom lashes and I realized there was nothing on them. So after top mascara and fake eyelashes, you should probably apply a bottom mascara as well. So that looks a little bit better. So that is the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching this far into the video. All the links to my Instagram, my second YouTube channel, like my vlog channel, my Facebook page, my Twitter, my Tumblr, all of those links will be down below, along with all of the products that I use. Also, please do like the video if you did enjoy it, because it's just a small thing, but it really does make me feel good. And yeah. So yeah, have a great day or night, and I will see you next week. Bye.